happened in Haven Point is catching up on us.
Uh-oh.
Huh? What do you mean?
When we were in town, we saw some stories in the papers. The feds are definitely tracking us down in the region.
Shit.
And they'll find us.
Well,
time to get going.
Figures. This couldn't last forever.
So, this is it?
See you, Nana. We'll leave tomorrow.
Can you hand me that bag, Sean?
What's inside?
That's why I brought you back here. I made these for the 4th of July, but this is better.
Oh! I love those things!
What is that?
Whoa! Awesome!
Cool. Let's light up the sky.
They are looking for you. They'll be able to see that from miles around. You just made a beacon. Hopefully the walls of this canyon or whatever it is blocking it for the most part. What's a newspaper say? That them? Their picture? So a picture of two people.
Are you guys all set up to leave?
No. Such we have to leave again. I think I'm kind of scared.
Oh, honey.
How far is the border?
How far is the border?
Not that far. Maybe 5 or 6 hours drive. It won't be easy crossing that border. So I'm gonna give you a head start from the police.
Wait, how?
What's your plan?
Yeah, how?
The cops are after me too, for what happened in Nevada. So they can catch me instead of you. Fair trade.
Mom, you'll go to jail for helping us.
It's not about me right now. We need to get your asses to Puerto Lobos.
It's about you for your life. You don't have to do that.
You don't have to do this, Karen.
I let you guys down before. Not this time. I knew what I was doing when I came to Haven Point looking for your brother. I felt it was the right thing to do.
It was.
And I feel the same today. I tried to live by my own rules, no matter what. I don't expect you boys to be like me. But try to stay true to yourselves. This is your life. Don't let anybody get in the way.
Hmm. We'll do whatever it takes.
Fuck the rules. We'll do whatever we can to survive.
That's right.
That's fair.
Yes, it is. You took care of Daniel all the way from Seattle to Arizona. Nobody could ask for a better brother. Or son. Okay. This is the last roundup.
Wait, let me say bye to Joanne.
So what's she gonna do exactly?
I'm gonna go do one last checkup on the truck before you hit it. And don't forget what we talked about. It's your life, Sean. You should go see David. He has something for you.
Okay.
All right to Karen?
Okay.
Hey, Mom.
Hey, Mom. I know you're better with words than me, but still, here it goes.
Thanks for Daniel.
It was so good for Daniel to see you again. He needed that more than anything.
In a way, see you for the first time. Don't give up on your freedom.
Please don't give up on your freedom. Okay? It's the best thing you've taught us. We'll reach you once we find our own freedom. Thank you so much. Love. Sean.
Okay. Leave as is. Thought he might say something about it. Anything new?
Had no clue there was a network of seed pirates. Karen takes on some small piece works for a living. Must pay better than poetry. Brody's so good at describing painful I miss you too, sis. Hope we can take some new pictures someday.
Same stuff. Check on David. Raccoon sweater. Raccoon has two C's, doesn't it? It's cool David brought something for Daniel. July 2nd, treasure hunt. When did he find the time to do all this? What does it say? Sunlight of future nightmares. Huh. Beat art, do crimes. Cool to hang out with Joan for a bit. Crimes? Crimes. go full derp. Last night away. I'm so glad Jacob and his sister are doing okay. They deserve some peace.
Okay. Should go see what David wants now.
Clothes. Nope, we tidy our clothes first. Because now he's going to say that line over and over. Old gift, yeah, look at that. Open? Wait. Box.
Huh. Is that the same person who wrote her back in Beaver Creek?
August 4th, 2010. Hi, Rumi. Yes, I know New York and August is hot as balls. You did say you liked the heat, but my apartment under the roof can be really suffocating. Don't want to rub it in, but Aspen is my new summer home. Daily temp around 70 degrees Fahrenheit and hot tub at night. Anthony's cabin is more like a ski lodge. Next trip, maybe you can tag along. Port's retreat. Best cure for your writer's block. And please let me know when you can pay me back for August's rent. I definitely need it for next month and up here in Aspen. I'll see you on September 5th instead of the 4th, so put your clothes on. Stay out of trouble and remember to water my babies this time. Love you, Emma.
She was that close. Sucks she had to pay all that money back.
Ravensbury Press. July 21st, 2010. Dear Ms. Reynolds, pursuant to our conversation on June 10th and your inability to submit your poetry manuscript the other way to Ravensbury Press by the contracted deadline of June 1st, 2010, despite repeated efforts to accommodate you, we regret to inform you that this breach of contract means we shall no longer be publishing in the collection as part of our New Poets series. As stated in Section 6 of our contract, see attached copy, if the author fails to deliver the manuscript by the agreed date, the publisher has the right to recover the full amount of the $10,000 advance. We have included with this letter a repayment form and schedule. Damn, that's a lot of money. As stated in Section 23 of our contract, see attached copy, the rights for your manuscript shall revert back to the author upon full repayment of the advance. If you have any further questions, please refer them to our legal team. We wish you the best of luck with your future endeavors. Sincerely, Alistair Moon, Poetry Editor, Ravensbury Press, New York. Well, so they... If she ever paid them back, she owns her poem, otherwise they own it.
This place has too many adults.
Huh. Many adults.
But I'm gonna miss it.
Oh, newspaper.
Look at that.
Yeah.
They won't ever leave us alone.
Police seek family after Nevada fire. FBI and Nevada police are searching for a woman and her two teenage sons after a suspicious fire destroyed a church in Haven Point, Nevada. It's these two photos that I noticed. Okay.
She looks kind of sad to let us go. But it was bound to happen.
Yep. I'm just gonna check around first at other people and things before I go to David's.
Okay, let's check you out one last time.
Joanne's the first real artist I've met. I'm glad I could learn from her.
Woodcutter who lives underground and he can fly.
Oops. Didn't think that was gonna happen.
Hey. What's going on?
I'm taking a look at this baby with hindsight. So, what do you think?
Looks very cool.
Looks very cool. I can totally tell what you're doing.
Good. That makes one of us. But I like it. Of course, you and Daniel did inspire me.
I love it!
So, you guys leaving now?
Yeah, just wanted to say goodbye.
That's sweet. You're so sweet. Your brother is so sweet. Having you boys around was the sweetest thing.
A lot of sweet going on.
This is for all your help.
Really? Whoa. That's great.
Cool. Do I get anything?
Your name is on a way bigger sculpture. For everyone to see.
That's true. I didn't think about that.
Yeah, your brother needed a little something to remind him of the artist inside.
Wicked.
Okay, one big hug. And get out of here before we all start crying like babies.
Thank you, Joanne, for everything.
Just please take care of yourself. And my special apprentice.
No worries. We always do.
Hey, is it okay if I hang out a bit longer?
If it's okay with her.
Oh, are you kidding? I need more help. So long, Sean. Don't be a stranger.
Oh yeah, their names. So yeah.
I'll miss you so much, Joanne.
Joanne.
I know, sweetie.
Just Joanne.
I'll miss you too. I had so much fun and inspiration building all these things with you.
Me too. It's the first time I use my power to actually build something. I usually just use it because I have to.
Hey, don't worry. I'm sure we'll get another chance to work together. Once you're settled.
Yeah. I hope so.
Okay, dude. Don't forget about David.
Yeah, just listening to them. We don't want to sit and draw. No drawing. Visit these two first.
Hi, Sean.
Hey, guys. Wish I could be as cool and as wise as these guys when I get older. I came by to say adios. We're taking off today.
No, you're not. Really?
Yeah.
Everything okay?
Yeah, just time to go.
Well, shit. Wish you and Daniel could stay longer.
It's true. A little too risky for everyone.
Yeah. But it's too risky, especially for all of you.
We all took a risk moving here. Look, we can hide you from the cops.
Not these ones. They want my ass. It's better if we leave now.
Sean, I won't drag this out and get bitter. Besides, you and Daniel will be back to visit, right?
We will try. Eventually.
We'll try. I'm glad this place will be our last U.S. memory.
You and your little brother will always have friends here. And a home. Okay. I'm done babbling. I just hate goodbyes. I know you're both gonna have a great life in Mexico. You better.
We're gonna make it work. Shit. I'm gonna miss you guys.
Take care. You hear? Watch out for Daniel. He needs you.
Be safe. And send us a postcard to the beach.
Gonna be near a beach? I forget. I don't remember anything about Puerto Lobos except it's in Mexico and that's where their father's
from. Can't wrap my head around those two leaving. That's just unfair. Daniel just got his mom back.
It would be weird to be back on the road with Daniel.
It wasn't forever, honey.
After all this time in a community.
They have their own way to go.
All talking over each other. David's trailer.
David always wants to help. But he's tough to figure out.
Was that the one who came back from town with his mother? I was wondering who that was.
I hope the UFOs are listening.
Yeah. Alright. Let's go in. Or knock. Then be let in.
Sean.
Hey.
Oh, you got license plates for us?
Karen said you wanted to see me.
Yeah, but go grab that police scanner inside first. I gotta put these new plates on the car.
Sure. I'm on it.
I'll join you when I'm done.
Are these fake plates or something? Oh, let's grab that last picture.
Must be his wife. Time's taking a serious toll on him since this. Poor guy.
Is that Chloe? And that's the jerk? Dave? That's that David? I can't go back out and look at him.
Must be his wife. Time's taking a serious toll on him since this. Poor guy.
Well, he's a much nicer guy if this is that David and that's Chloe. And her mother? That's crazy. Okay. He's a lot older. Jeez.
Arthur said David could fix anything. He hopes. As if money could make up for everything he's lost.
Madsen. Yeah, it's him. He was working as security in high school? Okay, it'd be high school or in the college. I forget. I really hated him. He's from Life is Strange, the first one. I really couldn't stand him at all. Neither could Chloe. Dear Mr. Madsen, enclosed is your most recent deposit statement from the City of Arcadia Bay as per your negotiated settlement for damages. Please ensure that the amount is accurate and that your bank has processed the latest deposit. Well, if you have any questions, please contact us Monday through Friday, 8 a.m. to 5 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. Best, Darren Barr, Agent Glenn Rose Insurance, Portland, Oregon. Wow. So, yeah, I guess he got an insurance settlement. Act of God with the hurricane, tornado, whatever storm that hit as a result of Max's powers. Picture.
They look cool. I wonder which one is his daughter.
Is that supposed to be Chloe and Max? That'd be Chloe, that'd be Max. I think. Polaroids.
Cool portraits. Didn't think David had a taste for the arts.
Yeah, just Polaroids. Tin cans.
Yep. David is ready for that apocalypse.
Huh.
Or whatever.
CDs.
Yeah. Me and David won't be sharing any playlist.
Huh. Oh, yeah. Hope he draws the covers before doing anything there.
Please. Please don't let the cops come looking for us out here.
I don't know. Hopefully, when or if they do, you'll be long gone.
That must have been the best meal ever, to frame it on the wall.
Was that whale diner?
That must have been the best meal
ever. Two whales.
To frame it on the wall.
Remember going in there. Two Whales Diner. Alright, I guess. Ooh, missed that.
Damn. I see why David ended up out here. But he still was a hero.
V. Chase. Oh, Victoria Chase? Trying to remember. Sounds so familiar. Dear Mr. Madsen, sorry this is so late, but I put the wrong P.O. box address on the envelope and the letter was returned. Hope this one finds you. I'm glad you left Arcadia Bay, or what's left of it. I'm now going to therapy, which helps, but I still get nightmares. I hope that Max and Chloe are keeping you company. They're a good team. Right, a peer of theirs from the high school. We started out hating her, and then turned out she was just a messed up kid like them. Trying to fit in, kind of thing. I'm still in Seattle looking over my parents' gallery. Their partner, Jessica, is great. She's taking care of everything. The will is a mess, but I will be okay. It's hard to get over the fact that, in a way, I owe my life to Mark Jefferson throwing me in his bunker. I get flashes of his creep face all the time. Oh my god, that was horrible. But then I see yours coming to rescue me. I'll probably be thanking you for the rest of my life for that. Yeah, serial killer. Yeah, see the first Life is Strange game. It took a really dark turn in... was it... Chapter 4 or something? Please keep in touch at this address for a while and let me know if there's anything I can help you with. Thanks again for your service. Best wishes, Victoria Cheese. Wow, that was cool. Glad I got that all the way up there. I almost missed it. Alright, the police scanner.
Wonder where David got this police scanner.
He might have had it all this time.
Okay. How does this thing work?
Wasn't he a policeman at one point as well? Toggle power. I'm just supposed to bring it out there.
Okay. Only gotta search between 140 and 160.
Trying to turn the knobs. Alright. Use. I was supposed to bring it out there, right?
Wonder where David got this police scanner.
Take it. It says take it from... I can't take it. How am I supposed to take it? Maybe if we turn it off now we can take it? No. How do I move it?
When we're in Mexico, we won't have to deal with this shit anymore. Wonder where David got this police scanner.
Am I supposed to unplug it? Is it plugged in? Am I supposed to look down here for a...
As if money could make up for everything he's lost.
What? I can't take it. It won't be taken. It refuses to be taken. Let me out. Damn. How am I supposed to take the police scanner? Okay. He won't pick it up. The option is not there. Maybe I'm supposed to try different things. And buttons. Ah! Okay. Didn't say. The 140. Oh, wow.
Still not the right one. Come on.
Haha. I like that. I like that.
That's all I'm saying, folks. But
nope. Definitely not.
Oh, yeah.
You can't even look at a tree anymore without getting some fine or new regulation. If the earth is getting so damn hot, I mean, why is there snow?
I applaud you, sir, for not buying into the
That's not how climate change works. It's displaced cold air.
You all know I have spent my whole life
Yeah, talking BS.
And here you go. Another hit from the back.
Nah. Nothing there.
Well, I didn't realize CBs could pick up FM stations. Oh god.
Dr. 136, listening. We've got reports
Wait,
of
is this it?
Down by Sam's?
Now we can spy on the cops all the way to Mexico. Thanks, David. You big rebel.
Okay. Big rebel. Oh, there's a wolf. Joan's gift. Joan really believes in my art. Makes me want to keep on drawing. Good. Either spell it differently or just call her Joan. Daniel would rather have these things. Oh, that's not it. So where's our thing? Or does it show up? Oh, it's in our little HUD here. Got it, finally. I had to fiddle with it first. Hello? Das map. So, we have family there?
And your mom's car is all ready to roll.
People gonna know who we are?
Did you get the police scanner?
Yep.
Yep. And I found the police frequency.
How about that? Good job. Now, you'll always want to know what they're up to.
He looks so different.
No surprises on your way to the border. Alright. This is the fastest route.
Better off with the beard. The mustache, other than just the mustache. And his hair was black, wasn't it? It's more brown now.
When you get there, cross between these two stations. Now, you have to exit the main road and drive through the desert for a while.
Mm-hmm.
But Karen's car should be okay. You got all that?
Got four-wheel drive?
Sure. I think so.
Sean, you have to know, the police are on your ass.
I know.
You only get one chance here. I'm not trying to be a dick. Just honest.
You did enough of that in the first game.
I know, David. Thanks.
Here. Have a seat.
Can't believe it's David Madsen from the first Life is Strange.
Don't mean to order you around. Bad habits die hard.
Mm-hmm.
And yes, I was suspicious when Karen showed up with you two. But after watching you and your little brother for a while, I think I get what you're going through. When our town was destroyed by that hurricane.
Yeah.
My stepdaughter and her friend were among the only survivors.
That's the canon ending?
We lost everyone else.
Huh?
Jeez.
That's the canon ending of Life is Strange? most of the town died and they just drove off in their car at the end. Huh. That was one of the choices you had. Otherwise, the choice was that... I think Max dies? I forget. Wow, that's amazing. So you have a canon ending for Life is Strange. The first. Did not know this.
I'm sorry.
I used to hate them for running away.
Yeah, they left.
They hit the road straight away.
Mm-hmm.
Never to look back. While I was trying to rebuild.
Yeah. She would have just destroyed the place again eventually, Max. Well, wasn't her power burned out by that? But you never know if it'll come back. But it was the repeated use of her powers that ended up destroying the town. So... do you get along now?
Did you stay in touch? Do you get along now?
Yeah. Took me a while to acknowledge the past was the past and move on. Like they did. Once I realized that, I reached out to them, and we made peace with each other.
Good.
They stayed here for a while.
Oh, really?
It felt good to connect with my daughter at last. You guys remind me of them, in a way. And I don't want to fuck things up this time.
That's good of you.
Sean, I'm going to do everything I can to help you get out of here. That's... my duty now. But I want to be straight up with you.
Oh,
okay?
Straight up again.
Yeah. Of course.
Everyone's saying this.
I know you guys got screwed. That you think nobody will ever believe you. But the truth is on your side. You and Daniel can't just hide out forever. Is that how you see yourself in 10 years? If you step up and face the law, you can be free.
Maybe.
Sooner than later.